Hello again and welcome to Fussels TV, and you wouldn't believe it, guess who we've managed to secure the services of again, the one and only John Mellon. Good morning.
I'm alright, Timothy. How are you? Nice to be here, actually.
Nice to see you. We're really starting to enjoy it.
Very good. Absolutely.
Now, we've got something with a difference here today, haven't we?
We have, actually. Yeah. Once again, in the spring season, got some nice section of vegetables coming in, and we've got some mackerel in today, Tim.
Well, the mackerel in particular, I'm very, very keen on. Yeah. Now, this mackerel comes from Falmouth, caught yesterday, I believe, and it's been supplied to us by White Row Farm Shop, which is just up on the Beckington roundabout. So many thanks to White Row and Phil in particular, who I went up to this morning and just gutted these two mackerel for us. And today we are going to grill them, I believe. Is that right?
Yeah, we're going to take these off the bone. I mean, obviously, just to indicate, I mean, obviously, not everybody buys, but we buy a lot of things in the supermarkets this day. But if you can buy a fish whole, good things you're looking for. Clear eyes, firm fish, obviously blood in the gills, which we've obviously got here, and obviously we want a nice smell. We don't want a stinky smell.
So what you're going to do is you're going to show us how to fillet this, then we're going to grill it, and what we're going to do as well is we're going to create a lovely salad with some fresh horseradish, some apple, some beetroot, and some Jerusalem artichokes, and some rocket.
Exactly.
Now also, you've got the machine over here, so I think you're going to get me to do some stuff with some
beetroot puree. What I'm going to do first, Tim, I'm going to get some, basically in a nutshell, we do a nice mackerel salad. Yeah, in the summer, nice girly dish. I'm going to roast some beetroot off, some artichokes, some fresh horseradish, some nice julienne of apple, bit of rocket, bit of peppiness, bit earthy, bit wintry, but also a little bit of a spring texture coming in.
Right, so let's show us how we can fillet this.
So, first of all, we're just going to, I'm going to get the beetroots in first.
Right, so now this is the thing, we've already roasted, John's going to show you how we do this, but we've roasted some beetroot. You're going to put some chilli oil in there. You can use any of the flavoured oils, but you use the smoked oils flavour, you can use the chilli or the garlic oil. Mm. Now, of course, the interesting thing here with that smoked oil is it's all available from Sainsbury's and Morrison's, and if you want to find out where your local store is, then go over to www.fussels.com/foods, look at our stockist page, and you will find out where your local store is. So, John, you've put some garlic in there.
Put some rib seed and put a garlic, put a salt, and I'm basically going to roast these. Obviously, this size, you're looking at about an hour and a half.
Anything bigger, longer, anything smaller,
You just want to put a knife through them, they're done.
That's all you've got to do. Put a knife through them, they're done.
I'll put these in.
So they're all doing it, and now we're going to
So, obviously, what I'm going to do, go through the fins, take them out first, take them out there. Yeah, take them out the fin there. Okay, and obviously, now, quite simply, if we have a pair of scissors, which we do.
Oh, right, okay. Are you going to take the tail off?
Take the tail off.
There we are.
Nice, impressive. Take the fins off. Do these now so it's easier, and then I think we're there.
Okay.
Obviously we've washed this, now you give it a good wash, get inside the guts, get all that out and all that kind of thing, and very simply just go down on the plaque here. You can hear lots and lots of bones in the mackerel.
I'm really interested to see how we do this.
So basically all we're going to do is just
take, and I think the thing that goes without saying here is we need a sharp knife.
Yeah, without a doubt. So all we're doing here is, you can see, follow the bone, follow the bone.
Yeah.
This is the trick, Now, the other thing I was going to say is, with mackerel, is that there's a lot of bones in it. There's a little trick we can do here, is to get the bones out, And that is perfect.
Look at that, perfect. So,
we stop the clock. How long was that?
Oh, I don't know. Well, that was probably about 2 minutes. So
we've got another side here.
So have we got bones in here still?
Yeah, we have, We have got those bones. But what I'm going to do, because normally I find the second fillet trickier than the first.
Okay.
Because you've got the firmness to hold it all up. So all I do, the second one, you see it clicking through the
fish.
So all you need, fish, just like a salmon. So all you're going to do is basically get all through all this, and you get it all off like that. Bang, done. All right?
Okay.
So, and then we're left with them. So we've got two nice fillets, easy peasy, get rid of all the discolours. Now you can make a nice, I suppose you could make a soup out of this or something like that. But
so you could make a fish stock.
Yeah, but it's an oily fish. You wouldn't really use that stuff for that. Always wash your hands after using fish.
Okay,
so I'm going to say next process, I'm going to wash my hands. So I'm going to have guts and stuff, so.
Now we've got our two lovely salmon fillets here. John's going to take a few more bones out. Then
salmon fillets?
Sorry, did I say something like that? Now, one of the, I have some wonderful fond memories of catching mackerel out of the buck of a sailing boat and eating them as fresh as a daisy. And I can see that these are going to be very, very similar.
So what I'm doing here is I'm just going to decut these out of here, yeah? Basically, so I'm left then with that. And then we'll just cut down here off the fillet end here.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so we're left with this here. Oh, sorry. Yeah, sharp knives are quite key. There we go. So, and then what I'm going to do now, normally you get like a little pin knife and all that kind of thing, yeah. But I'm not going to do that today. I'm just going to go in on a V. Yeah, so I'm going in like that, yeah. And I'm going in like that, yeah.
Okay, so we're taking out, and now we're going to
move. On a V, yeah?
Yeah.
So we'll just go up.
And I can still hear the bones clicking, so is that going to pull the bones out now?
Yeah. So this should pull the bones out, yeah. Easy.
He says easy.
Yeah, and then just go in here, take these out of here, bang. So, all done. Bonus mackerel, yeah?
Bonus mackerel, look at that.
All done, yeah. So yeah, let's disregard that. And then I'm not going to use the other one, but
could
use the other one.
We can.
I bet it for time we won't.
I'll tell you what, we'll just get that one in, shall we?
Yeah.
We'll get that one
and
in.
Then what I'm going to do with this is,
so we've got a tray here.
Yeah. Is put this on here. A little bit of salt.
We do a lot of seasoning, but the salt. What does the salt do, John?
Seasons the fish.
It seasons the fish.
Weirdly, I know. So we need a bit of chili oil.
And we're going to put a bit of chili oil over there. So that's going to give it a bit of bite as well.
And a little bit of lemon juice. Yeah.
Now these are things: your bowl of salt, your lemon. Almost everything we've been doing has had a combination of these two factors.
Now, how long is this going to take to cook? Now,
about 10 minutes.
10 minutes.
Is 10 minutes too long?
I'm not having fish in your house.
Right.
Yeah, I reckon maximum 4 to 5 minutes. Yeah.
4 to 5 minutes. So again, the underlying theme here is not to cook too much.
Exactly.
And we are then going to allow, we're going to have the old residual heat gain.
I'm going to put that there. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to put this away. And I'm going to clip a little clean down. And I'm going to basically...
And what am I doing anything with
you? You are, yes. What we're going to do, I'm going to get rid of all this fish. I don't need like contamination stuff. I'm going to turn this board over. Okay, and then put it back on. So now what we're going to do, we're going to get the beetroot. Sorry, Tim, I'm back now, yeah? Anyway, I'm back. You're all right, I'm here.
Right, now this is something I'm really looking forward to. This. Am I chopping these before they
go? Yeah, Tim, we've got a blender here.
You've got a blender?
Yeah, and we're going to put all this in here. We have your dressing here. So what we're going to do, we get all this in there, the beetroot.
So I'm going to bang those in here.
Yeah, and
then. I'm not even going to cut them in half,
yeah,
really.
Yeah, just throw it on.
Just throw it
on. And then get it going on, and then what you want to do when it's
blown, I've got to push that down the side.
Yeah, that's it.
Now, am I going to get. There we are. Okay. There it is.
Let me do it.
Now, I don't want to do it too much. I don't want to overdo it here, do I?
You want to puree.
I want to puree as you can. I need it more than that.
I want to push it down on the sides.
I've got to push it down on the sides.
And then you want to get some of this going on.
There we go. Look at that.
God, I've got this.
Oh, my goodness.
Sorry,
Tim. Now, I can smell this beetroot here.
So the grill's on, so literally we need to get everything ready first so that basically we can, just literally the last thing going on the plate is the mackerel.
It's the mackerel, so that's only going to take 4 minutes. So are we doing, we need to bang that in yet or not?
No, not yet, not at all. So what we'll do, we'll get that down to a puree.
I'm just going to mention again, while I'm pureeing this beetroot here, we've just added a little bit of the English herb dressing.
Yeah.
Okay, that's all available from our website.
Perfect.
And you can also come over here to Fussels HQ and buy that one. And if indeed you do, you can get any three products for £10.
Fantastic. So what I'm going to do now, Tim, I'm just going to literally get this. This is Jerusalem artichoke.
Jerusalem artichoke.
Okay. Now I've washed these. Yeah.
Yep.
Now I want the really earthy effect on these, so that we get the flavour of it.
Okay.
And so what we're going to do is finely slice these, and we're literally going to put them in salt and a little bit of
lemon.
Lemon, yeah, a bit of salt, a bit of lemon, and also a little bit of your oil as well. And what this actually acts like, it acts like a radish.
Okay, yeah.
You know, like in radishes you get?
Yeah.
But it's to do so much, you don't get like that effect. You'll get the peppery now from the rocket.
From the rocket.
So we'll just use this like, as a radish. Quite a clever idea.
I think that's a fantastic idea.
You know. So now we're here with this, I'll have a try it of this beetroot. How do you find it?
Tried it yet? No, I haven't tried it yet.
Haven't tried this.
You know he's not going to enjoy this.
I need a bit more salt.
Maybe I think we need a bit more of Fussels English.
Yeah, that's right. A bit more acidity. Yeah.
Yeah, I think we do.
Yeah, so try that. I think
a bit more salt in there. A bit more salt in there. Hang on, there we are.
That's it. Yeah, that'd be. Okay, so now I'm going to get these marinated. So little bit of salt, a little bit of lemon juice, and a little bit of your. And then now what we're doing, Tim, I'm actually going to get your. So I'm going to use the smoked rapeseed again in these.
You're going to use the smoked oil?
Yeah.
In there, right, okay, that's with the artichokes.
Yeah, so now I'm going to put the mackerel in.
You're going to put the mackerel in the oven. Amazing, yeah. Now the key thing here as well is what, I always get a little bit panicky. Now John reckons it's going to take about 4 minutes, and what he's very, very good at is bringing all the ingredients together.
Hopefully.
So that we get the dish all ready and presented. So we've probably got about 4 minutes to go,
yeah,
and we'll all be ready. So we've got artichokes in there, the artichokes, the beetroot.
It's good, you're probably a salmon.
I know. So we've got the beetroot in the oven with the smoked oil and the garlic.
We've got our
beetroot puree here.
Yeah, we've got a nice beetroot puree.
That salt has made a real difference. The salt in
the sodium's a great. I'm not keen on pepper, really. I am keen on
it. I do like a bit of pepper, but that's you can tell that's much more rounded now, isn't it?
Yeah.
Right.
It's bottom to the table.
So I'm just going to move this out of the way for the time being. Yep. So I think you're going to ask me to... Oh, no, you're going to chop the... This is the roasted beetroot.
Now, this is the roasted beetroot. Now, you can see they're still quite hot.
Yeah.
Yeah. And...
Now, this is with the skin on? This is...
Everything. No, I'm going to take the skins off.
No. You roasted them with the skin on.
I have, yeah. Sorry, yeah. All I'm going to do... Do you want to peel one? Give me a hand. All I'm going to do is just take the skins off. And all you want to do is just do that. They're going to be quite hot. If they're too hot for you... I'll do it for you.
No, right.
Too hot to handle.
Too hot to handle. Now this is something. I'm much more comfortable with the three most important words in skiing. Do you know what the three most important words in skiing? Are?
Help, help, and help.
No. It is actually feet.
Yeah.
And.
I'd still say help, 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 and help.
No, it's feet, feet, and feet.
Oh, is it? Yes, so I was right.
The three most important words. Now, what seems to be the three most important words in cooking is fingers, and fingers.
Fingers.
Yeah, he seems to have asbestos fingers.
I do, yeah.
Not that he's got any asbestos on there.
Absolutely not.
So, now we're looking at about 3 minutes before the...
So now we've got beetroot going on.
So this is when it gets exciting and we start to bring it all together.
So now what we're going to do...
We're
just going to dice these up.
Yeah.
Okay, nice and just so they're bite sized. So you can, when you're eating them, you can eat them together. So if you just try that, sorry,
it won't bite.
Yeah. So you get the difference. Yes. Taste it.
Mm. Well, now the difference between the beetroot here, which has been roasted, and the beetroot which has been pureed, is quite subtle.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
But we've just got a bit more of a crunch here.
Yeah.
I can taste some of the garlic and the smokiness, whereas in this, it's much more salty. And we've got the flavour of the English herb dressing.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, can I ask you a question? You said you had a phobia against beetroot before.
I'm actually quite enjoying it. I'm really enjoying it.
Really?
My kids will go mental because it's the one thing I say I don't really like.
Yeah.
How are we doing over there?
It's quite smoky, but
anyway.
But Tim,
so is that coming
all
nicely?
Tim, we're looking like it back in a minute.
We're looking like another couple of minutes and we're ready.
We're going to plate now.
We're going to plate. So, what are we going to do with our rocket apple?
If you pass me over the. Over the stuff, and we'll start building out. So what we're going to do is, this is the beetroot puree, so we're going to have a little bit of this at the base of the plate. What this will do is, a little bit on the plate, yeah, like that, easier.
Yep.
So a little bit of beetroot on here as well. One, two, miss a few, 99, 100, yeah?
One, two, miss a few, okay, fine. So this is the bit I love, when we start
building this. We could dress this, but we're going to dress it afterwards as well, yeah. So we've got all the artichoke going on here.
One thing we are missing is the apple, though.
What the apple does, it brings it all together.
It's
the acidity of the flesh.
Yeah, but I'm concerned where I can't see it anyway. It's coming, okay, fine.
So we've got a bit of apple there. And then literally now, it is the apple time.
It's the apple time.
So I've used red apple. Simple reason is because... it's a nice effect on the plate. It gives it another dimension of the colour. Yeah. Normally I julienne these a lot more, but I think
you julienne them. There's another word which my friend is going to have a go at me for.
Yeah, there will.
Now this is julienne means basically
just chop. I julienne these nice and fine.
Nice and fine sticks.
Right, yeah. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I want everything to have a mouthful. I want mouthfeel.
Yeah.
You know, so everyone can have a go at the same. Go at the same time.
Okay. Fine.
So do you want to get a grater out of there and you can out of here, Timothy, at the bottom drawer. Yeah.
There we are, there's a little crater.
Yeah. Ooh.
So and here's our fish. Now again, that's remarkable. That's only been in there maybe 4 minutes.
So can we have a look underneath it? So we just have a little check.
Oh my goodness gracious me. It's ready. It's ready.
So a little bit of lemon juice,
A little bit of lemon juice on
And I'm just going to fill, I'm just going to put a little bit more chilli oil on it, yeah?
Any salt on here at all?
Nah.
No? Are you sure?
Yeah, positive. I just tried the tray. It's
really?
Fine. Absolutely, yeah. Lovely. Let the fish do the talking to it.
There we are, right, okay, now we're
going to
just pop that on top, are we?
Oh, yeah, lovely. And then we're just going to put some artichokes, we've got on them already, so just dress this with the artichoke juice here. Yeah.
Now, what is that? We've got a little bit of oil in there.
Yeah, a little bit of artichoke juice, lovely. So this is acidity, yeah? Got lemon juice, and it'd be lovely with the salt as well. So, and that's it, Tim.
That's it, and I knew we'd put a bit of salt on.
That's
right,
it.
So can we just move this one out of the way?
I'll get that Tim, that's
get that one out of the way. There we are, we'll move this baby out of the way as well.
So we'll put that on there, so nice and easy, yeah. Nice little salad, easy peasy, lemon squeezy. If you've got a knife and fork, try to tip your lady. That fish is so tender. Oh, you want a knife and fork?
Well, right, so now we're just going to take a couple of photographs of that before we get tacked in. But that again, I can see it's a very, very simple dish. I'm going to give you my comments in this. Are you going to grate some?
Of course.
Look at that.
A little bit of horseradish at the end.
A little bit of horseradish with some rocket. We've got some apple. We've got some pureed beetroot. We've got some roasted beetroot. We've got some lovely grilled mackerel. There is, I for one, I'm looking forward to. So we can get stuck in there, John. We've had a thumbs up from Monsieur le Directeur behind the camera.
A lot of French today, Tim.
Well, you know what I'm like with my.
Yeah, you took in. Yeah, you took
in. Right. Now I'm going to try and get some mackerel and some.
He's not complaining because there's bones in the fish. I'll be really unhappy. How long? But you didn't take as long. I mean, director, how long did that take us?
Right. Now just be quiet because I need to.
The horseradish, huh?
Oh.
You can feel the horseradish, can't you?
And there's a real bite to this dish.